He is a musical enigma. Initially, pursuing this career path for him was a stigma. He is a bookworm, but not because he reads for fun, but because he's a CA by education. And then he decided to run. And so he ran towards music and became one of India's top EDM producers. He is also one of India's top female models, and he's quite a seducer. Music producer, DJ, visionary, seductress. It's time to put all hands on deck and welcome the one and only Sartek.
There'll be discussions.
There will be chats.
Mental combustion.
Ooh. At the drop of a hat.
Some topics can be so vast.
So vast, mind blast.
We'll keep it quick, we'll keep it fast.
Podfast with the Shant.
Hello and welcome to Podfast. Sartek needs no introduction, despite that we've shown you his little intro video. But one thing that I do want to mention is that recently Sartek was featured in the 200 most influential people in the music business in Asia by the New York Press Agency, alongside the likes of A.R. Rahman. That truly is a commendable achievement, and congratulations to you, my brother. We are also proud of you.
Thank you so much. What's more exciting for my mom was coming on a video with A.R. Rahman. Get about the 200. Then she told me, now I think you're doing something good in your life.
Moms will be moms. Yeah, they find their own yardsticks. Yeah. But lovely, congratulations to you again. I'm sure this is just one of the many, many things that Sartek has achieved and will be achieving over the few years. Bro, so now this is called Podfast. So I'm going to come right to it. So what I want to discuss with you is that, according to you, what is the future of EDM? Keeping in mind that EDM is now getting integrated so seamlessly with other mainstream genres like hip-hop and pop, yeah. EDM on its own, where does it stand and where is it headed?
What happens with any genre is that they have a life. Now, if you go back to school times, remember the rock was so big. There was Limp Bizkit, Linkin Park.
It starts with one thing. I don't know why. It doesn't even matter how hard you try.
Oh, yeah. Good old memories.
When hip-hop came, Snoop Dogg, Eminem. And then suddenly, when we were in college, there were Tiestos and Armin's. Dance for life. And now it's like a cycle. So now it's going back again to those hip-hop thing is coming back slowly and slowly. So what happens, EDM music got big because of America. Majority of festivals happen in America, the biggest ones. And because the drug scene was big there. So I'll be very honest with you. So the people started losing patience of listening to big breakdowns, big vocals. All they wanted was a party music where it's tick, 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 and they were dancing. So that's how EDM came in between. But what happened with the stress levels of people losing jobs, recession in the world? So music is emotion, right?
Correct.
People stopped enjoying aggressive music. And because of Spotify, Apple Music, the streaming came in between. So when streaming came in between, the stream, a grandma, 80-year-old grandma and an 80-year-old kid, they all have a phone and they all know how to use Spotify in Western countries specifically. Then these labels decided, okay, now let's give EDM a break because this kind of sound is only catering to a younger group of audience. So now EDM got involved with Future House, Future Bass, different genres came in. In short, what happened is the aggressive music became more of an emotional kind of music. Loud beats, those dancing numbers became a very melodic kind of numbers.
That's where you saw the trend of, like, you know, deep house became really big and things on those lines, things which were a little more mellow and not necessarily just party music.
And that's where the chain smokers got the right timing. Hey,
I was doing just fine before I met you.
Correct.
They thought that EDM is going down. What people are liking are cheesy vocals. So let's do some cheesy vocals and mellow kind of beats, which are not exactly EDM, but not exactly pop also. But if you're asking about future, your first question, I would say EDM will never die because the festivals can't survive without EDM. There are techno festivals, there are deep house festivals, but they're like 5 to 10% of the EDM festivals. So you will always have Armin van Buuren or Hardwell headlining a stage. Right now it's down, I would agree with you, but I think it's just a phase. Probably in the coming 6-7 years, EDM, the circle will come back.
Right. And like you very rightly said, genres evolve in ways that you can't anticipate beforehand. Yeah. Even something like hip hop, which has come back now, in a massive way. The hip hop that we get to hear now is very different from the hip hop of the 90s or even the early to mid 2000s. You know, when we were in school, we used to listen to Eminem and G-Units and the likes and the Game. And now you have Travis Scott and Drake, etc., who have a very different style of hip hop. So maybe going forward, even EDM will evolve and develop many new styles. It has already branched out into many sub-genres. But this evolution is a constant, I feel.
Exactly. So I was producing 130, 132 BPM, which is like typical trance and those heavy bass lines. And now I'm looking for a vocal which is, you know, soothing. The girls listen to. It's like a nice club vibe. It has to be an emotional song which turns into a happy song in the end, you know?
Nice, so lovely. Lovely. And knowing Sartek, you can count on him to always have his finger on the pulse and always come out with new styles without losing his own identity. In fact, his latest track is an absolute banger. It's called Kaziranga, which you must check out. So besides that, Sartek, what else can we expect from Sartek? What's next in the pipeline?
So what I'm doing is, I was very late to this, but I've just started a YouTube channel. Instead of focusing only on Hindi and English, I'm working with vocalists from different regions of India. I'm working on a big Bengali folk song. There is a big Malayalam song coming towards the end of this year, like I think December last week or January first week. Maybe some people saying it's a promotion technique. Why not? But I realized that my market with the EDM audience is done. The saturation level has reached. Now let's go and explore different regions in India and get a different fan base.
Wonderful. Yeah, I think that is so cool because that in itself is a part of evolution of music or the styles of music. Yeah. That if you know, one genre can get merged with another genre, then why can't various languages come into a genre? And that is super cool. I feel that, you know, how he's touching upon different regions of India. Obviously, I haven't heard any of this music, but I know for a fact that it will embody that region, the culture, and also what Sartek brings to the table.
Best part about those songs is that even if you don't, like, I don't know Bengali, you don't know Malayalam, right? But if you listen to those songs, you don't need to understand the lyrics. Right. There's rhythm in itself.
The biggest track on YouTube, Despacito, a Spanish track, I think 90% of its fans don't even speak Spanish. Yet, it was such a banger. I mean, people flipped it over Cola Veridi. Flops. So music is more than just words and vocals. It goes way beyond that. It's a rhythm that you feel deep within. Wow, what a line. I think I should clap for myself. Awesome, Sartek. So what I want to now get into, Sartek, are some fun and games. Okay. So I'm going to start off with the rapid fire bazooka lightning round.
Okay.
It's a rapid fire with bazookas and lightning. I'm going to ask you 5 questions. You know the drill and you have to respond with the first thing that pops in your head. So question number 1, Nike, Adidas or Balenciaga?
Has to be Nike. I don't know what's the big fuss about Balenciaga.
I think it's because of your track. Everyone loves Balenciaga. Next question, your favorite Sartek track?
So there's a track called Backed Up, a typical EDM track. Why it's my favorite? Because that track was rejected by all the labels in the world. And that track changed my life. Nobody was buying that track. I uploaded on different forums in Russia, in Belgium, in Holland. And that was played by Hardwell, Tiesto, Danik in the live sets. Hardwell, I asked him that how did he find about this track? He was like, he was searching music on a local Dutch forum.
Right.
I saw this track and love the beats and he made a mashup. So amazing. That's when I realized that labels are good, but imagine a track which nobody was buying was the track of my career.
I'm also waiting for one such life-changing opportunity. Maybe my interview with Sartek will be it. My next question. Yeah. Your favorite collaboration till date?
Tere Karke with Paji. This was the first song where I actually left my comfort zone of working with the same kind of typical EDM beats. I met this Paji at a wedding drunk at the bar.
Wow.
Paji remembered the chat we had at the wedding and he called me. I went to his studio. I just heard one phrase of Nike Adidas Pake Karte. Paji, let's do it.
For once, a drunk conversation actually followed through and converted into something. Okay, so Sartek, next question. Besides you, who is your favorite Indian producer?
A lot. I think Ritviz is doing a fabulous job. There's a guy called Zenith who's upcoming. I really like what Mojo was doing recently. Yeah, the few first names come in my head.
Now, my last question. Is there anything you wish you had done differently with your career?
I was playing a label game, getting all my promotion done from the labels. Now I realize that you yourself are the label, you are the marketer, you are the producer, you are the DJ, you are everything. So I wish I had a YouTube channel by the name of Startic Music back then. I would have at least have a million followers by now. Now it's been a month and we're on 1,000.
Arre, don't worry. It's a matter of time knowing you.
Yeah.
Great. So that was the rapid fire bazooka. Lightning round, and thank you for those bazookas. Now, this round is over and I have one more round, which is called True or False. I'm going to throw four statements. Tell me if it's true or false. First, Tiesto once performed under the moniker The Joker.
True.
That's right. True. Second, the term disc jockey or DJ was coined in the 1960s by an American radio show host. True or false?
I think false.
That is correct. And because, would you care to guess who was behind this term?
Somebody in Britain, in Europe?
No, it's
UK
false.
Or Europe?
That. It was coined in 1935 by the legendary radio show host Walter Winchell. Back in 1935. So that's how far back this term goes.
That's interesting, yeah.
Next statement. Not a single member of the Beatles could read or write music. True or false?
I would love to say false, but I think it's true.
It's true. There you go. So you can imagine the biggest act in musical history could not read or write music. That's a fun fact for you guys. So my last statement is, in the year 1518, a small town in France had a dancing plague wherein dozens of people died due to uncontrollable dancing. True or false?
It's true.
It is true. Yeah. As weird as it sounds, and rest in peace. But dozens of people actually died because they couldn't stop dancing and their bodies finally gave up and they had cardiac arrest because they were dancing for 3-4 days straight without a break. Yeah. And, you know, scientists are baffled till date as to why this happened. Maybe Sartek was playing a set. You never know. Awesome. So thank you so much, Sarthak, for coming on this show. I know you are running a busy schedule, so I really appreciate you taking out time.
I love it, bro. And let's do one of the sessions offline also. I think we only had drunk chats at different bars in Delhi. And I love your true-false game. It's so interesting. Thanks.
Perfect. We'll play another game offline. I'll have some more politically incorrect statements this time around. So anyway, I hope everyone had a wonderful time watching this show. And I hope people who are aspiring to enter this space got to learn a bit through Sartek's experiences, his insights and his inputs. And we'll be back next week with another celebrated professional from the creative, media, or entertainment industry. Till then, stay safe, shake your butt, and we'll see you next week on Podfast with Dishant. Pin drop.